In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. My dear friends, warm greetings and welcome to Carmelite. It's the Thursday of the 11th week in ordinary time. A reading from the book of Sirach, chapter 48, verses 1 to 14. Then the prophet Elijah arose like a fire, and his word burned like a torch. He brought a famine upon them, and by his zeal he made them few in number. By the word of the Lord, he shut up the heavens and also three times brought down fire. How glorious you were, O Elijah, in your wondrous deeds. And who has the right to boast which you have? You who raised a corpse from death and from Hades, by the word of the Most High, who brought kings down to destruction and famous men from their beds and easily destroyed their dominion, who heard rebuke at Sinai and judgments of vengeance at Horeb, who anointed kings to inflict retribution and prophets to succeed you. You were taken up by a whirlwind of fire, in a chariot with horses of fire. You who are ready at the appointed time, it is written, to claim the wrath of God before it breaks out in fury, to turn the heart of the Father to the Son, and to restore the tribes of Jacob. Blessed are those who saw you, and those who have fallen asleep in your love. For we also shall surely live. It was Elijah who covered by the whirlwind, and Elisha was filled with the Spirit. In all his days he did not tremble before any ruler, and no one brought him into subjection. Nothing was too hard for him, and when he was dead, his body prophesied. As in his life he did wonders, so in death his deeds were marvelous. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. My dear friends, the sacred author in the first reading that we just heard proves his great admiration for the figure of Elijah, who wrote no book but was a courageous prophet of action. Sirach is writing in the 4th century BC and offers a striking parallel between the present times and its turn of events to those that were parts of its history in the 19th century BC. 9th century BC, the time of Elijah. In this way, the prophets of his time would know how to react with courage to the loss of faith on the part of the chosen people of God. In short, we can describe Elijah as a prophet like fire. Due to his zeal for the one and true God, the responsorial psalm is also a summary on Elijah's spirit and mission. What a beautiful eulogy. Would somebody speak of us in similar terms after our death? Just question yourself. Would somebody speak of me in similar terms after my death? And if not, why? And if not, why? The same book of Sirach states, "Have regard for your name, since it will remain for you longer than 1,000 stores of gold." Chapter 4, verse 11 to 12. "Have regard for your name, since it will remain for you longer than 1,000 stores of gold." It is not necessary that we do all those great wonders and miracles that were accomplished by Elijah, but we must all learn to be faithful to God and learn from their courage to be prophetic in our mission. In the gospel passage, Matthew chapter 6, verse 7 to 15, we have reached the heart of the Sermon on the Mount. That's prayer. It fits so beautifully when the contemplative dimension of Elijah, who had an intimate experience of the presence of God on Mount Horeb, Jesus offers us his model of prayer, a prayer that we can say summarizes the whole spirituality of the Old and New Testament, and especially the Sermon on the Mount, with themes of pardon, love of enemies, the Heavenly Father, his perfection, the kingdom of God, and the daily bread. So this prayer has also a pedagogical value, teaching us what to do. The prayer is teaching us what to do. Let us pray. Today in the Konkani Bible Diary, you find Godwin D'Souza from Gurupur celebrating his birthday. We wish him happy birthday and we pray for his intentions. Also today, we remember all our listeners, their intentions, our benefactors, well-wishers. And we pray the novena prayer to infant Jesus. In a moment of silence, my dear friends, let's remember our personal intentions, intentions of the needy, to those whom we have promised our prayers. O holy infant Jesus, through your life on earth, you reveal to us by many marvels your hidden power. So now bless us abundantly with your uplifted hand and graciously gain to hear your petitions and graciously deign to hear the petitions of those who call upon you in faith and trust. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O Holy Infant Jesus, bless us and hear our prayers. O miraculous Infant Jesus, look upon us as we turn to you, imploring your assistance in our needs and anxieties. Let your compassionate heart be moved to pity by our supplications, and grant us the favor which we urgently implore you. Free us from all affliction and despair, all trials and misfortunes, and give us your support and consolation, so that we may praise you and the Father and the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. Thanksgiving prayer. O most generous Infant Jesus, we on our knees have come to express our deep thankfulness to you for all the favors we have received at your hands. We believe, Jesus, that together with the Father and the Holy Spirit, you are our Creator and Savior. Henceforth, we place all our trust in you. Through this miraculous statue, may your devotion be spread throughout the world, and may all people pay homage to your holy childhood and gain thereby untold divine blessings and favors. All praise and honor be to the Infant Jesus. Amen. Pray for God's blessings, my dear friends. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Have a wonderful Thursday, my dear friends. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye.